When you open up your Ancestry DNA results, you might be amazed by how much we can tell you from just your DNA. But how exactly do we figure out those percentages for so many different places around the world? First, we analyze the DNA in your saliva sample, and then look at around 300,000 specific markers to determine your ethnicity estimate. Nearly everyone has a different set of markers. That's what makes you uniquely you. The next step is to understand the ethnicities and percentages in those markers. We need to recognize and identify the patterns of DNA linked to a particular region or population. To do this, we group together DNA samples from people with long family histories in particular parts of the world. Each of these forms a reference group for a given population. Next, we divide your DNA into over 1,000 different sections. Then we compare each section to each of our reference groups. If a section is most similar to our Ireland reference group, it gets labeled as Ireland. If it is most similar to Japan, it gets labeled Japan. We repeat this with each of your DNA sections, and then total them up. If 30% of your DNA looks like the DNA of people with a long history in a particular region, then your results will show that. Because your ancestors didn't always stay in one place, some of your results could be closer to where that DNA originated and not where your family lived. It may sound simple, but it's a very involved process that relies on cutting-edge science. We keep adding to the reference panel and optimizing the algorithm we use to compare your DNA to our reference groups, allowing us to add more regions and leading to improved precision in your results over time. DNA science is always evolving, so remember to look at your latest Ancestry DNA results whenever we make an update. As more people take the Ancestry DNA test and science progresses, we can give you a higher level of precision on your results. And for 2021, we have some exciting updates to share. We've added two regions to West Asia, the Levant and the Arabian Peninsula. And to Africa, we've added Egypt. The Aegean Islands make up another new region in Europe, and we've added Bengal to Asia. In addition, we're adding three new indigenous regions in the Americas, Panama and Costa Rica, Ecuador, and Chile. Representing the people of the world fairly is our priority. We work with a diverse network of scholars and experts to develop and review how our regions are named. A larger reference panel allows us to improve results for most areas of the world. Even if your DNA is not from one of these new regions, your results could be even more precise than they were before. We will continue to add more people to the reference panel and refine our algorithm, so stay tuned for new updates in the future.